Complete the proof that opposite sides are congruent. So here we are given parallelogram ABCD, and we're going to prove that segments AB and CD are congruent, and segments AD and BC are congruent. So our proof is already set up. Let's take a look. ABCD is a parallelogram, that's given. Draw segment AC. Through any two points, there exists exactly one line. And also notice down at the bottom, the final statement, the proof statement, is already in place. Now, the purpose of drawing line AC here is to create two triangles, and our goal is going to be to prove that these two triangles are congruent and the unused corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent in order to say that we have opposite sides congruent. So our first goal is going to be to prove that these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, now the statement that goes after draw segment AC is going to be about the parallel segments. Because we have a parallelogram, we know that segments AB and CD are parallel, as are segments AD and CB. And the reasoning is definition of parallelogram. So next, because we know the segments are parallel, and we drew AC, we have some alternate interior angles. In fact, we have two pairs. So those two pairs of angles are congruent. Alternate interior angles theorem. And next, we're going to say that segment AC is congruent to itself by the reflexive property of congruence. And that is going to give us enough information to prove that the two triangles are congruent by angle side angle. And the AC is the included side on both triangles, and the two pairs of angles are the two pairs of alternate interior angles. So now that we have triangle ABC congruent to triangle CDA, we can use corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent to say that the opposite sides are in fact congruent. So that's how you complete this proof.